Teachers, students, and parents, welcome to our performance of Little Women, a one act adapted by Marisha Chamberlain from the novel by Louisa May Alcott. My name is Benedict Dingle. I'm the middle school theater director and the director of this production. 안녕하세요. 저는 드라마 감독 Benedict Dingle입니다. 와주셔서 대단히 감사합니다. Tonight, please follow these rules during tonight's performance. 안내 사항을 지켜주세요. No flash photography during the show. Flashy 안 됩니다. No filming. We are filming the show, and the cast and crew will be able to get copies later, and it will be on KISJ YouTube channel. 녹화는 안 됩니다. 우리가 녹화합니다. There is no intermission to this show. It is 1 hour long. So if you must leave during the play, please leave your seat quietly and return to your seat quietly. Oh, this is a hard one. 중간에 쉬는 시간이 없습니다. 자리를 비워야 한다면 반드시 조용히 움직여 주세요. I feel so fulfilled right now. Please do not distract the actors on stage. 배우들이 방해하지 말아주세요. And that's it. Thank you very much for coming. Enjoy the show. 와주셔서 대단히 감사합니다. 즐거운 시간 되세요.
In the beginning, you're just a young thing, just another creature of the universe, and you hardly know that you're a girl. You're so busy learning to walk and run and ride if there's a horse handy, or to live off an apple tree. You want what you have. No, you want more.
War.
I don't think it's fair for some girls to have plenty of pretty things and other girls nothing at all. We've got father and mother in each other.
We don't have father and home for a long, long time.
Well, there's a war on, and I think it's splendid of father to go as chaplain, as he's too old to be a soldier. I wish I was a soldier.
I suppose we have to humor her.
We don't have father, but we have me. And what we're going to do, girls, is to make our own kind of Christmas.
You aren't father.
Well, I just take his place. He says, a homemade Christmas of our own invention, I say.
You pretend you're father because you wish you're a boy.
So what if I do?
And you want any excuse to box us.
Oh, fiddlesticks. The play of embarrassing girls, why don't we present it to Mother for Christmas?
Yes.
It's almost ready, if you know your lines, Amy.
Well, I do know my lines.
All right, we'll have to play. And that's not all.
Last Christmas, we had plum pudding and cranberries and oysters and presents all around. This year, we have corn pudding with raisins. Raisins, mind you. At least Joe and Meg are old enough to go out to parties. But Beth and I would have to stay here at home with our raisins.
Well, I won't be going to parties. My white muslin dress is worn out and Joe spilled tea on my tongue too.
Don't peek, Amy.
It's not just a tea thing. The dress is torn and mended in three places. We don't seem giving out at the back.
We'll pretend you're a poor foreigner just blown in from a storm or a spy under orders to attend parties.
And what is so wrong with parties?
Don't get her started, Amy.
People ask you to dance is what, and you're hurt if they don't, disgusted if they do, and then you step on their feet.
Which is what you do anyway, isn't it, Joe?
If you want dance, Joe, at least you can flirt.
Flirt! If you're gonna flirt, then I'll have to stop you, because before you know it, some young man comes calling. What's that on your nose, Amy?
It's a clothespin.
If you're gonna hang a clothespin up there in the breeze, Amy, you might as well wash your handkerchief and hang it.
Are you seriously not going to take the clothespin off? Anyways, a young man comes calling to try to marry you.
Some young man comes calling, and then?
A young man comes calling to try and marry you.
Boys.
Yes, unless you're a boy yourself, then you can stand with your back against the wall and frown down on everything.
You also do that every time.
So what if I do? Anyways, then they marry you and then you cook and sew to take care of you sweet and pretty and every feature extinguished and your adventures are over and you might as well be dead.
Listen, Joe, Marmy married Papa.
That's different. They're our mother and father.
Don't worry, Joe. If I have to look ragged at the school, the party, I'd really rather stay at home.
Shoo, Beth. I'll let you see in a minute.
But I must go dressed raggedy every day to school.
School is not a party, and yes, you must.
Well, we're meant to go out and see the world. I only mean it's best to stay at home for Christmas.
Nobody stays at home but me.
Do you like to try school again, dear?
No, I can't simply bear so many faces.
Well, you're bashful, Beth. But your piano takes you to places, doesn't it? To lands of enchantment. I'm writing a storybook, by the way. Now, how's this?
A Christmas present. It's for me, isn't it?
Amy!
Where did you get it, Joe?
I bought it with my Christmas dollar.
You were supposed to spend it on yourself.
I did. I spent it to please myself.
It's not for the new boy, is it? Miss Lawrence's grandson? I know you like to watch him ride his horse.
I would like to meet him, but I'd hardly give a present to a boy I haven't met.
I guess, Miss Ford, you're too far afield.
It's for Mother!
Yes, it's for Marmy. I thought that'd make me happiest. Let's crack it. We have carols and plays to sing. And there's one present for Marmy.
Two! I bought her a pearl glove.
And I bought her handkerchiefs.
Bravo, Meg. Bravo, Beth. And I kept my dollar.
It's all right, Amy. It's yours.
It's just that I haven't decided how to spend it yet. If I'm to be an artist, I must have pencils. Famous drawing pencils.
Mmm, what's a glorious smell coming from the kitchen? Must be pudding. Hannah, how's the pudding?
Don't shout, Joe.
Rehearsal, everybody. The Witch's Curse, a Christmas opera.
What has Christmas to do with it?
I'm working that in. Hannah, would you come out, watch our rehearsal? The fainting scene isn't right.
Hannah, what are you cooking?
You saw everything that went to it, dear.
Just corn pudding with raisins? Smells delicious.
Watch this, Hannah. When Amy faints, it's supposed to be shocking. A great lady has fainted and all that. So, bell sounds. The curtains fly apart. The forbidding tower, there. The beautiful Zara stands in the tower. Zara, Amy?
How soon may we eat, Hannah?
Not till evening. I should be pudding.
You stand here, Amy. Put your mind into fainting. Oh, Zara, beautiful Zara, I give you one final chance or you die.
Let me guess it. Here I go. I'm fainting.
You can't just faint into a chair. You have to just drop. Look here, clasp your hands. So this is your line, Amy. Rodrigo, save me, save me!
Rodrigo, Rodrigo!
She sounds like someone is sticking with pins.
Amy, are you even trying?
Yes, I'm trying, and you're not so brilliant. You don't look like any Hugo the villain.
Well, wait till I put on my big red boots. Ta-da! Observe the glint of my sword!
And you sound like you got a frog in your neck, and I don't want to rehearse this stupid old play.
A frog in your throat, Amy.
Is that so?
I'm bored to tears with it, even if you did write it.
Well, when the audience laughs, don't blame me.
They won't laugh. They'll say I'm pretty.
Marmy and Hannah will say you're pretty, and that's all you want out of your life. Christopher Columbus!
It's not, and don't swear.
I'll swear if I like it, and what's more?
Don't, Joe. It's boyish. I detest rude, unladylike girls.
And I hate nimby pimby chits. Where do you think you're going?
I have an errand.
You can't go now.
almost done.
Really, girls, you're both to blame. Amy, sometimes you're entirely to proceed.
And how is Joel to blame?
You have an errand, then you'd best be on your way.
Come back directly. I know exactly what Meg will say.
You don't need to tell her, Meg. She knows.
It's time to let up your boy's trick, Josephine.
Josephine? You best not call her Josephine. I don't think she'll ever answer to Josephine. Aunt Marge called her Josephine.
Not at your tall, Joe. Not at your tall. And turn up your hair. You must remember that you're a lady.
I'm not. And if turning up my hair makes me one? There. In the beginning, you're just a young thing. Just another creature of the universe. And you hardly know that you're a girl. You're so busy learning to walk and run.
And ride if there's a horse.
You're not helping, Beth.
And suddenly they tell you, not that you're grown, but that you're a lady. And you best be so someone can take you and pick you like a doll from the toy shop shelf.
Well, perhaps, but what else can you do?
Make my own living?
You will work dreadfully hard.
Well, I look forward to it. I wonder what that Lawrence boy is doing now.
Preparing for Christmas alone with his grandfather.
That does sound lonely. I guess I wouldn't be changing places with him tonight.
Well, you can't. He's rich and you're poor.
Here's Marmy. Strike up, stoke the fire. She's home. Three cheers and a hallelujah.
Hurrah, she's home.
I'm so glad that you're enjoying Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Marmy.
Sit here.
It's not my birthday.
You'll see.
Where are my slippers?
Just you wait.
Where's Amy?
She's on some mysterious errand.
Here I am. Merry Christmas, Marmy.
Merry Christmas.
Here, open this first. You'll need them.
Slippers? Any slippers?
First rate arm issue.
Junior, thank you. And for Mac?
Gloves.
Lovely. Children, how did you manage this?
You know what we did?
You spent your Christmas dollars on me?
I hemmed them myself, but the stitching's crooked.
Handkerchiefs hemmed by your own hands. Thank you, Beth. And for Amy?
It's the large bottle of cologne, not the small one. Though I was terribly tempted by drawing pencils, but instead, see? It's the prettiest present of all.
Is that so?
And I'm truly trying not to be selfish anymore.
Girls, you've been all so much generous today. Supper? And here we are.
Hurrah for Hannah!
Hurrah for the pudding!
Applesauce and hot tea and cream. Girls, there's something weighing on my mind. Miss Hummel and I have 5 children. Now look at that. I just stopped to see them, only to find out all 5 of them and the newborn baby huddled in one bed to keep them freezing, for they have no fire and no people either.
Oh, well, it's good you told us before we began eating.
Yes, we'll give them our supper.
Our whole supper?
Yes, we will go.
Let me push the wheelbarrow. All right, I'll carry the pudding.
Good, and firewood. I chopped a sack of firewood. Capital, Marmy. While you and the little girls go out to the Hummels for supper, Meg and I will set up for the play.
What play? What play? Is there a hero in the play? A villain in red boots?
It's a new play, Marmy.
Don't tell her the book, Bess. Promise, Amy?
I'll not reveal a word.
Goodbye. I wonder what that Lawrence boy is doing now.
Joe, come help me here.
Dark. Good.
at Rodrigo, I cried.
Curse Rodrigo! Curse Rodrigo!
Who is invoking the witch's curse?
I, Hugo the villain. Give me a poison to kill Rodrigo, and a potion, a love potion, to make Zara love me.
I hate Ricky Hugo. I spit in his eye. He shall take his own poison and die.
May he call me Rodrigo! And may I present the beautiful Zara? Rodrigo! Rodrigo!
Don't sing, Amy. Do you know you can't sing? Isn't Amy pretty?
Ugh!
And Joey's so good at both parts, you can hardly know that they're both the same person.
It's just a masterpiece, a masterpiece.
Carry on, Amy, all the way to the top. This doesn't feel very steady, Joe.
Come on, I promise it'll be steady, just all the way to the top. Someone's at the door.
What's the matter out there in the audience?
Thank you, Hannah. Sorry, Joe. Please proceed.
All the way to the top, Sarah. All the way to the top. Sorry. I told you so. I told you so.
Sorry. Sorry, performance.
invite, and they've gone and done it. This is your day, Beppy.
Marmee, Beppy.
Oh, Marmee, the piano.
Oh, my lord.
Do you think it's real?
Why don't you go and find out?
Go ahead, Beppy, go ahead. Here. Joe? Oh, open that later. My lovely storybooks from Joe. Oh, thank you, Joe. Thank you. But how can I ever thank her?
Well, if I'm not too much mistaken, she's hovering near the window waiting for you to hear me.
What shall I play? Oh, oh!
She kicks her heels, she bats her eyes, she bats her low-cut gown.
Wait a minute, Meg doesn't own a low-cut gown.
Be quiet, Laurie. What should I... Except in my bag and my daughter's robe, Meg's back from the poor eccentric bookish family.
Oh, are you ashamed of us, Meg?
No, I didn't mean it. I'm so glad to be home.
No, Meg, I'm the one who's sorry. Betty, you have your piano. I'll go congratulate Grandfather. Here, Joe, they should fix things. Open it now, it's for today.
I didn't mean any of that, Joe. Mommy, I want to fess up. It's true. I wrote, I flirted, I drank champagne.
You flirted? But we discussed about that. We said no flirting.
I let them dress me up in bar frippery.
You wore a low-cut gown?
But then, I started to feel peculiar. The gossip, they all think that you have plans for us, Mommy, that you want us to know Larry because he has money, so he'll marry us. I mean, one of us.
How peculiar.
It's not peculiar, it's ridiculous. I'll tell Lori, won't he shout?
You mustn't tell. Have you no pride?
All right, I won't. Or to be splendid old maids.
That's right, Joe. And either way, be ready for the duty and capable of joy. Beth and Amy, shall we fetch a food?
I had the beastly time. Meg, is it true? Did you really flirt?
I tried, but I don't know if I succeeded.
You won't get all silly on me, will you, Meg? You won't turn all stupid and blink and pine after young men? Mm. Because Lori's invited us to the theater. Here's my kind of social occasion.
Don't shout, Joe. We're standing right under your mouth.
What's under your nose? For heaven's sake. What did you say, Joe?
Lois invited us to the theater to see the Hall of the Mountain King this very afternoon.
What should we have to wear?
Wear whatever. We're at the show. We're the audience.
You just go off and leave Beth and me at home?
You can't go, Amy, so don't be a baby about it.
You must let me come too, Meg. I've got nothing to do and am so bored. I'll ask Lori. He'll say yes.
Suppose we take her. Mother won't mind.
It's rude after he's only invited us and to drag Amy in.
You must let me come too. Make as I may.
You can't, dear. You aren't invited. Gloves, Joe.
where these poured lemonade on it, and both are spoiled.
Quick, take this glove and grab your spoiled glove crumpled in your other hand.
Walk home, girls.
Here's Laurie. I shall go too. You can't go, Amy. We're coming, Laurie. You'll be sorry for this, Joe March. See if you aren't.
Fiddlesticks, Amy, just drink your tea.
I'm sorry, Amy. Would you like to play checkers?
Beth and Amy, I'm going to a village where I read. Would you like to cook?
I think I would. No, thank you.
Well then, goodbye, Amy.
Bye.
That was glorious! The swordplay and the fire effect?
Thank you so much, Laurie.
Mr. Brooke? John. Please call me John.
Bye, Laurie.
Bye, Mr. Brooke.
See you in a bit, Joel, speaking.
Right.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Hello, Amy. Hello, Amy. Someone say hello, Amy.
Hello.
Amy, you've done something. I can see it in your face.
Guess Beth's not home. Oh, hello, Beth.
Hi, Joe.
Hi, guys.
Tell us about the play.
I'm dying to know.
Well, it was called The Hall of the Mountain King.
We know what it was called. You think you can see right through me, don't you? You think you know everything. You think you run the world.
You've messed with my drawers out, haven't you?
No, I haven't.
Pens and papers?
The play had a story?
Well, first, the prince comes in satin robe and then some little elves all in green.
Nothing wrong with my writing stuff.
A prince and elves? And what else?
Beth, where's your storybook?
The storybook that I just finished writing for you.
No, it's not here.
You've got it in, haven't you? You know where it is then?
No, I don't.
That's a lie. Where is it?
I don't know where it is because it isn't anywhere.
What?
You burnt it?
You burnt it up? You wicked, wicked girl! I finished that storybook. I can't write again and I'll never forgive you as long as I live!
Amy, how could you?
You know how mean she was.
You can be sorry for being mean, but you can't bring her book back.
I'll never forgive you. She doesn't deserve it. Don't talk about me like I'm not in a room, May.
I want to comfort you, Amy.
What's all this?
Oh, Marmy, Amy has gone and...
Me and Joe went to the theater, and Amy wanted to go too, but she wasn't invited. And then
I threw Joe's book into the fire, and I feel like I murdered something, and all I can say is I'm sorry. All right, I am sorry. I'm truly terribly sorry. Please forgive me, Joe. I'm very sorry.
I'm never going to forgive you.
How could you have done something like that? I've written that storybook for years.
Laura's out there. Come to take his skating, Joe.
Tell what happened. I can't see anyone.
Just go here. Don't think. Just go.
I shall go too.
Amy, do you really want to make things go worse?
I'm not invisible. I want to show her I'm sorry.
Anything?
Amy, what is it?
She fell through the ice.
Oh my God.
I skated too far ahead and Lori pulled her out and...
She'll be fine, I think. Let's get her straight to bed.
It's all my fault. You did it all, Lori. I skated far ahead, though I knew she'd find us. And if she died, it'd be all my fault.
Joe, I think she's all right.
Come, my boy.
Thank you, Miss Lawrence. It's my dreadful temper. You can't guess how bad it is.
It's all fine, Joe. All worth it.
Are you sure?
Yes, Joe. And Joe here? I have a temper.
You, Mother? Why, you're never angry.
I tried for a cure for 40 years, and still, I'm angry nearly every day of my life.
You are, aren't you, when you fold your lips together?
Do I?
Yes, but you don't storm and shout. You have some secret.
No, it's not. It's a mystery. Mystery. Myself, I'm sometimes so bitter, but at other times, I'm able to control myself.
You need grace?
Yes, and life itself is a mysterious. What makes people do petty things that annoy? Terrible things that shouldn't be allowed.
You understand it's best not to explode.
Yes, and here's Amy. Don't carry me, I'll stand.
I'm so sorry, Joe.
Shh, Amy, I'm sorry too. Are you sure you're okay?
Yes.
Any bruises?
No.
Oh, thank goodness.
See what I said? They'll find a way.
I'm so glad Amy's okay.
Me too. I'm so sorry, Amy.
No, I'm the one who's sorry.
No, I'm sorry. Oh. Well, thankfully, you're not heavily injured.
I don't know how to do this. Can you help me?
Yeah, sure. First,
Perfect. You ruined it.
No, you haven't.
I heard the littlest girl fell through the ice.
I'm all right now.
But you fall through the ice?
Well, it was dreadfully frightening. The edges of the ice were sharp and jagged. The water was cold as Antarctica.
Really? Cold as Antarctica?
I believe she's recovered now.
Excuse the intrusion.
Mr. Rook.
Good evening, all. Good evening, Margaret.
Margaret?
I hate to interrupt, but I'm here to deliver this telegram.
Father?
Dear God, Father is going to get you friends. I must go. I'm traveling back.
Let me go with you.
Shh. I need you, Joe. Miss March, I'll accompany you. Do not travel alone.
Now, let me go instead.
Yes, please send Mr. Bruce to Miss Lawrence. I'll feel much safer to know you're here. Keeping an eye on my mom.
Mother, you're back. Bye, Marnie.
Bye.
Thank you, Mr. Rook.
Goodbye, all.
I suppose I should take the girls home with me. It's a large home, but it contains many valuable and fragile items.
Aunt March, you're so very kind.
Maybe I should take just one girl, a small, pretty one with lovely manners.
Aunt March, you're most kind, but it might cause jealousy and resentment if you took just one. And you can't take all. I fear it's not practical.
No, I fear not.
you.
You mustn't give us a thought. We'll carry on.
Girls, you'll be good. You'll be good to each other, right?
Yes, we'll be gilded angels.
We will! We will!
And I shall be father, uncle, and grandfather all in one.
Father, any messages?
Don't tell her I'm sick.
We won't. You're just tired. Then afterwards, I may write Mr. Brooke.
Do you mean Brooke, my tutor?
Laurie, that is Joe. You'll find Joe in the garret.
What? Is she back at the scribbling? Good.
That's not feeling well.
Are you sick, Beth?
No.
You may have a fever, Bethy.
Yes, a mild case. So is Joe. But not Amy. Oh my heavens, we have to keep Amy out of the house. Keep Beth there. We must keep Amy out of the house.
Why? What is it, everyone?
I'm sorry, I didn't think of exposing to others. Joe, you've had it. Laurie, have you had scarlet fever before?
Yes, I have.
Scarlet fever, Beth? I'll marshal take Amy.
I'm sorry, she is pernickety. But you manage her very well.
Yes, I understand her.
You must go right now, Amy.
I'll take Amy over grandfather's carriage.
Goodbye, Ben.
Goodbye, Amy.
Scarlet fever, Ben?
The Hummel baby was so sick, but I won't get the fever. I can't. Not with mother away.
It's okay. You'll have whatever you have.
Don't worry. We'll carry you back to him. Nothing
else. We won't worry your mother. I've nursed others to the fever, Bethy.
I will nurse you.
Here. We'll take the table and bring the cotton. Thank you, Hannah. Here.
Not any. I wish I could see Amy.
So do I, but if she comes to the house, it'll be too tempting, and she'll have to come in.
Oh. Letter!
One for Joe, one for Beth, and three for Meg.
Thank you.
And I've got a funny secret.
Tell us the secret, we could use a laugh.
Oh, but you've impressed everyone with your fever, but not me.
Glory!
I mean it, but I'm not impressed. Show me a different show, show me Grendel with his arm torn off driving Beowulf down the watery depths. That's better. Now Cleopatra driving a herd of elephants.
Actually, I've got a secret myself.
Do you know? You tell first.
All right. You won't repeat it to anyone?
Not a word.
Okay. You know the war story I just finished? I left it with the editor of the newspaper.
Oh, Joe, how wonderful.
Hush! It won't come to anything.
It will come to something. I know it will. We will sell you down the print, and when we meet Brother Arthur, I have to hooray! Hooray for Joe!
Shh! Now your secret. Play fair.
I know where Meg's glove is.
In her drawer.
No, it's not. Brooke has it. She dropped it in the carriage the day we went to the theater. Brooke said that he would be turning to Meg, but he didn't. He put it in his pocket.
Is the glove plain or lace?
Lace.
That's not Meg's glove, it's Joe's. And I'm afraid it's spoiled. I heard that it's got a big splotch of lemonade.
Doesn't matter. He thinks it's Meg and he carries it everywhere in his pocket. Isn't that so romantic?
No, I think it's horrid. Effie, you look a bit tired. I think I'll close my eyes. Do you hear music?
Yes, grandfather's playing by the open window for you, Beth. Should I tell him that you like it?
Yes, please. Thank you.
Arrive home today. His letter said he'd arrived at Christmas.
A mere 2 weeks?
Father Sobako! Mr. Brook!
Sorry for barging in.
You're home, Mr. Brook. Is Father with you?
No, he sent me on ahead. I brought his love and my love and our extreme sorrow over death.
Yes, thank you.
Is perhaps anyone at home?
Jo's home. Shall I call her?
No, just tell them I'm home.
Your umbrella.
Who's that?
Mr. John Brooke. And Father? Not yet. Father sent Mr. Brooke ahead of him.
Did Jo see anything else?
He said he brings his love.
Since when do we call him John?
He forgot his umbrella.
Jack, where is he? Oh.
Martin calls him John and after all he's done to help us, I think you'll like him better.
Well, if you call him John, he'll go romantic.
Oh, nonsense.
And if he does, what would you say?
I'll simply say I'm too young, that he's very kind, but we must simply be friends as before.
Good, that's cool and stiff enough.
And I will walk with great dignity from the room.
You promise?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yes. Mr. Rook!
Forgive me, I've left my umbrella.
I mean, hello, Mr. Rook.
Come, Amy, something's burning on the stove. Remember what you planned to say.
Hello, Margaret, what do you plan to say?
Margaret would like to see you, I'll call her.
Your mother's not here, I saw her in the village. Are you afraid of Margaret?
No, of course not. Welcome on, Mr. Rook, you've been so kind to mommy and father.
While I was away, your letter so much to me.
Yes, we are all so grateful to you, Mr. Brook.
Love and letters, so full of hope.
Oh no, please don't.
I just want to make sure if you do care for me.
I don't know, I'm all flustered. Please go away.
What's all this?
Hello, Aunt March.
I came to call on your father.
Father's not at home.
That's evident. And who is that?
His father's friend.
And what is father's friend saying to make you blush like a peony?
Mr. Brook came to get his umbrella.
That boy's tutor making a proposal?
Hush,
hear you.
You don't mean to marry this tutor. If you do, not one penny of my money goes to you.
I shall marry whom I please on March.
Heidi tidy. He's poor, I'll wager, and has no rich relations.
But he has many more friends.
He knows you have got rich relations.
Aunt March, how dare you? John is above such meanness. My John wouldn't marry for money any more than I would. We're used to being poor and we're willing to work. I shall be with him and he loves me.
Well, I wash my hands of the whole affair. I'm done with you, with all of you, forever!
Oh. Thank you for defending me. So you do care for me?
I don't know how much, since she insulted you.
So you won't send me away, but we stay together and stay together at Christmas?
Yes, John.
And shall we tell them all at Christmas?
Amy, somebody do something! John Frick is acting dreadful, Meg likes it!
Going to be a romantic Christmas.
Hurrah!
Seriously, Joe, you're just crumbling out of habit. Put your knitting down, we aren't little children anymore.
I don't like the look on your face. We're only 16.
And Mega 17.
Which is very much too young for anything.
There is something I must say, must ask you.
I have a suspicion on what it is. Lori, don't.
I must. Think of all of you to each other.
Well, I don't plan to listen.
You must. Think of all you're to each other. We do everything together, Joe. I love you ever since I met you.
Well, I love you too, of course, but not with a capital L. That's not...
But I mean the love with capital L.
I never meant to entangle with you.
I want to be entangled.
But you know my views on...
Marriage. You say that you're against it, but girls are so strange that they would never really know. So I must ask, will you, Joe?
No.
Marry me, Joe.
I can't say yes, Julie, so I won't say anything at all. I'm happy as I am, and I love my liberty too well. Not only that.
What? Say no!
I promise Beth. And I don't think I'll ever marry.
Oh, there'll come a time when you care for somebody tremendously and live and die for him. You will, and it's your way. And shall I have to stand by and...
Oh, I doubt that very much. I've done my best, and I'll never marry you. And the sooner you believe it, it's the better for the both of us. So now, we've had it out.
Just a moment. Where are you going, young man?
To the temple.
Joe, sir?
I've been wanting to meet you, Lori.
Mr. Margaret, I'll leave to your family, sir.
Only if you promise you'll be here this Christmas and not until the Christmas.
I'll try my best.
Can't.
No, perhaps not.
I'll sweep and work in the garden, clean the carpets, and iron the curtains.
Well, say no for now, but thank you, Lily.
Well, if you check the Lori, I think my friendship with him is over.
What about adventures? What happened to writing?
I don't care for it. It's childish.
I don't know this young woman. Something with a drug has here. There's an old pope.
Don't say that of me, Father. I can't help it.
I believe you could do anything you set your mind to. Really, Joe, you're trying my patience.
Oh no, please don't pay me any mind.
Joe, forgive our old father. Something terrible is weighing on me. You really must tell me. Come, this son.
It's just, I promise that I'll take your place and take care of you and mother in their old age, and I'm not going to leave you.
Oh, I see. And how did Bess respond?
I don't like to remember it. She was too weak to answer.
Well, I'm going to answer for her. Mother and father will take care of each other. Birds will notify the nest. If I stay with my parents, would I be standing here next to my daughter, Joe?
No, I suppose not.
You're growing up, and there's no stopping it. And as for your silly scribbling, why? Bass would have called it writing, wouldn't she? She was always proud of your writing.
Yes, when I think about it, she really enjoyed my writing.
So, go back to your writing again.
Yes, I'll go on and do it. I'll write more books and be a writer.
Good, that's my job.
And we're all finally together.
Finally,
all together.
I thought she was Dorita's forever.
Of course not. You just don't understand her.
All together, finally.
No, Clay, you must play now.
We miss Bess very much, don't we? But it's nearly Christmas, and I think Bess would want us to celebrate.
Oh, here's my boy. Have I told you the news? I'm sailing to Europe for a season.
Oh, Lori, Italy and France!
Thought she'd accept him. Girls are mystery.
Well, at least they know their own mind.
Come, Aunt March, Joe, and everyone, let's sing.
Thank you. That's our show. Tomorrow night, our second cast will be up, so it'll be a whole new, almost an entirely new cast. So you're welcome to come back, and please, on your way out, take note of the photography gallery that's going on the televisions, and the artwork all the way down as you exit by our middle school art students and middle school photography students. Thank you very much. Have a good night. And, Merry Christmas.